Crossing the Menai Straits from mainland Wales to the Isle of Anglesey was once a fairly worrying business. Ferries were slow and expensive, and the area infested with pirates and footpads. Even cattle being swum across to market were a prey to aquatic rustlers. The answer came in 1826 with the completion of Thomas Telford's Menai Suspension Bridge.
It's high enough for tall ships to pass under and sufficiently wide to open Anglesey to a flood of traffic. At first commercial traffic, and then increasingly pleasure-seeking. Anglesey's big attractions were, and still are, its wide sandy beaches and craggy bays set around a 126-mile coastline. The island has carefully maintained its Welsh identity. Street signs and public notices are invariably bilingual. And just 4 miles north lies the ancient town of Beaumaris, founded by Edward I after his conquest of Wales in the 13th century. Beaumaris was a thriving port until the opening of the Menai Bridge, when it found itself transformed almost overnight into a middle-class Victorian holiday resort. The town was endowed with a fine yachting harbour, handsome prom, and more than its fair share of historic buildings. The centrepiece is Beaumaris Castle, erected to discourage domestic insurgents. It cost £7,000, give or take a groat, but even this was too much for Edward, whose warring ways had landed him in financial difficulties. He had to cut back on castle building.
Much of the town was designed by Joseph Hansom, the inventor of the Hansom cab. But this structure he built for people who weren't going anywhere, Beaumaris Jail. It's a grim reminder of the harshness of Victorian justice, with, among other vindictive gadgetry, one of the last wooden tread wheels used in Britain.
The door halfway up the wall led to a public scaffold through which the murderer Richard Rowlands passed in 1862. En route, he cursed the church clock facing him. And that side of it hasn't been right since.
St. Mary's Church, in the hollow of the White Hazel, near the rapid whirlpool, and the Church of St. Decilio, near the Red Cave. That's the English translation of Britain's longest town name. It's now a tourist and souvenir centre. The trains still stop here, although the station is unmanned. Which is probably just as well, because by the time the announcer had said Llanfair Pwylth, Gwyn Gwylth, Gogere, Llandrobwyth, Llandysilio, Gogogoch, mind the doors, please, the train would almost certainly have left.
Still, it's a convenient stop for Plas Newydd, the traditional home of the Marquis of Anglesey, silhouetted against the Menai Straits and Snowdonia.
There's a splendid cavalry museum with pictures and relics of the Battle of Waterloo, including this mutilated pair of trousers over here. The story has it that towards the end of the battle, the Marquis of Anglesey, who was a general in the Hussars, suddenly turned to the Duke of Wellington and said, "By gad, sir, I've lost my leg." Some years later, an articulated wooden leg was invented. Anglesey got one, and the design continued in commercial use until 1914, under the name the Anglesey Leg, a legacy that hardly had the turnover of his commanding officer's Wellington boot.
Plas Newydd is a convenient day out for the folks who holiday down the road at the Plas Coch Caravan Park. It stands in the grounds of a converted Elizabethan manor house with a restaurant, bars, television room and discotheque. There's a shopping complex and safe children's play areas with pony trekking and yachting available. The busy social programme includes Welsh folk concerts and nosh and splosh barbecues at the poolside. You can bring your own caravan to the Plas Coch Caravan Park or rent a static one with up to 8 berths for £55 to £85 a week, self-catering. On the other side of Anglesey, near Holyhead, is one of the beaches for which the island is famous, Triathaw Bay. A wide stretch of sand for safe bathing, skin diving, water skiing, and a wealth of rock pools for small game hunters. The Triathaw Bay Hotel is one of the island's largest, with its own indoor swimming and paddling pools. Half board for a room with bath, radio and television starts at £13.50 a day. Holyhead is, of course, one of the traditional setting off points for Ireland. You can go to Dublin and back on a day return for just £9. It's about 3.5 hours each way, but with the early start, there's time for shopping and sightseeing. Another way of getting across to Ireland is on one of these coastal cruising boats, available for charter from the Scimitar Sailing School. The school is primarily in the business of teaching everyone from dry behind the ears beginners to those wanting to graduate to bigger vessels. For the latter, £90 a week covers food, onboard accommodation, and instruction in such things as radio and navigation. Those who are learning on smaller craft can find accommodation at the club's own premises with bar and restaurant attached. This 6-day, all-inclusive instruction holiday costs about £94. The club also provides facilities and instruction in other water sports, including sub-aqua diving and sea fishing, both highly popular and well-run activities on Anglesey. Here in Penrose, just outside Holyhead, hunting and shooting were once the main activities. But in 1972, a local policeman, Ken Williams, converted its 450 acres into a nature reserve. Now it's visited by 12,000 people a week in the summer season, and Constable Williams sports the MBE awarded for services to conservation in Wales. Scores of children spend their entire holiday helping around the place, clearing the pathways, planting trees, and helping in the bird hospital. Admission is free, and all the money collected in the donation box goes towards winter feed and other essentials for the 146 birds and animals which live here. Ken Williams caters for another form of wildlife in the area too. He managed to persuade the local authorities to send youngsters in trouble for minor offences to work on the reserve. The scheme has worked admirably. To date, none of the kids has got into trouble again. As for vandalism, there isn't any, because he's recruited all the vandals.
Ken, that's a falcon, I recognise that much, but what kind and how did he find his way here to the reserve?
This is the peregrine falcon, you know, the aristocrat of bird of prey, capable of speeds up to 150 miles per hour.
Good Lord.
Rare these days, but this particular bird was found on the slopes of Snowdon, having been shot, damaged wing and a damaged head. It'll never fly again.
But they are coming back into their own, despite being rare, are they?
Yes. A lot of them were killed during the war because they hunted the carrier pigeon. And after the war, lots of them died because of insecticides.
Some lovely stories about other creatures here on the reserve in your book, Wildlife in Custody, among them the seal.
Oh yes, my spaniel dog found a baby seal, so we brought it home here, wondered how the hell are we going to rear this one. You know, this was a good one. I rang up various people, you'll never do it, you'll have to pump 8 pints of milk in a day into it. I had the titty bottle for it, you see, and he wasn't looking at it. But I noticed when it was lying on the ground, in the house in fact, on the carpet, it was running its nose up my Wellington boot, up and down, up and down. So I thought, he must think it's his mother's tummy. And so I stuck the titty bottle up here, and straight away it started to suck. And that was the beginning and the end of everything. It was 8 pints of milk a day for a long time.
Boot-faced.
Yes.
What about the shell duck?
Yes, the shell duck, a very unusual story. People coming on holiday to North Wales, good place to come to, we're coming along the M1, and this party, a little shell duck, marched across the road. So they pulled up from the hard shoulder and collected them all, only the small little things, just a bit bigger than an egg, but 2 days old. And they brought them here. We reared them under infrared lamp. We ringed them with Natural History Museum rings. And now they're free to go wherever they want to, Russia, Scandinavia, Britain, anywhere they want.
When are you going to release them?
Today.
Can I give you a hand?
Yes, you can. Thanks very much.
But before that, I must just say goodbye from the island of Anglesey. On behalf of Judith and me and this series of Wish You Were Here, I hope you have a lovely holiday. Bye for now. Right, Ken.
Lovely birds, you know. Lovely birds. It's wonderful, this migration, like, is it? Nobody really knows, you know, Chris, what happens.
We don't know how they know where they've got to go to.
We really
or
don't
how
know.
To get there.
No, we don't. There we are.
Right.
Hold it. There you go. Got it?
Yes, I've got him.
There we are.
Okay, let yours first, and let's...
Oh. Cheerio!
Where he makes for. He's on. Fantastic. Right, here goes number 2. Good luck.